Hello students, in today's topic we'll be discussing about solution to ordinary differential equations for boundary value problems. And in this, the method which we'll be starting is shooting method. In the previous lecture we started about finite difference method. Now this is the second method, that is called shooting method. Now it's an iterative method to solve the boundary value problems. In this, the boundary value problems are first reduced to initial value problems. The missing initial condition to a given differential equation is guessed, and the solution of equivalent initial value problem is obtained. The solution obtained is compared with the boundary conditions, and a new guess is obtained according to the initial conditions. The procedure is repeated till the boundary conditions are satisfied. So it's an hit and trial method. It's a quite a bit lengthy process. In this method, the initial value conditions are solved using RK4 method. So let's take an example and then we'll understand how the shooting method actually works. For this, let's consider a very simple problem. There's a heating rod of length L, and there is a heat conduction occurring whose equation is represented by the second order differential equation d square t by dx square plus alpha into ta minus t is equal to 0, where alpha is, let's say, heat diffusivity, which is 0.01 centimeter inverse square. Ta is the ambient temperature, let's say 20 degrees Celsius. The length of the rod is 10 centimeters. At x equal to 0, that is at t equal to 0, it's 40 degrees Celsius at one end, and at the other end at t equal to 10, that is at x equal to L, the rod is at 200 degrees Celsius. Clear? So we need to find out the temperature profile, or you can say plot T versus L using shooting method. Okay, so now we have the differential equation with us. So let's first, you know, try to simplify this thing. So we substitute these values over here. So what we have is d square t by dx square plus 0.01 into 20 minus t. It's basically a linear differential equation. So with the boundary conditions that at t naught is 40 and t 10 is 200, that is somewhere here it is 40 degrees Celsius, and over here it's 100 degrees Celsius. So we need to find the temperature profile within this. We can use your finite difference method, you know, put the number of grids and find out the temperature difference. But in this shooting method, what we do is, let's try to convert this boundary value problem into initial value problem. So what we do is, we can convert into two, since it's a second order differential equation, we can convert into two first order differential equations by taking dt by dx as w, and the other equation will be dw by dx is equal to minus 0.01 20 minus t. Clear? Now for this particular ordinary differential equation, we do not have the initial condition. The initial condition is missing, whereas for this case, we have the initial condition that T at 0 is 40 degrees Celsius. Clear? So for this thing, what we do is, we're going to give any assumed value to this and we'll try to solve it. So for this, let's assume, so it's a first iteration, let's assume that W naught is somewhere equal to 10. It's any, you can pick up any arbitrary value, no issue with that. So W naught is 10. So the initial condition is x is 0, W naught is 10, and T naught is 40 degrees Celsius. And we have two equations, dt by dx as W, let's say that is first function, and the other function is dw by dx as minus 0.01 into 20 minus t, let's say that's the second function. So we can solve two simultaneous equations using a very well known RK method, RK4 method. Now, RK4 method says k1 is h times f x naught w naught t naught, and l1 is h times g of x naught w naught t naught. So let's calculate the value of k1. So k1 is h, now h, okay, since it's a rod of length 0 to 10, so let's take h as in this case 2, then we'll have four readings, 1, 2, x equal to 2, x equal to 4, equal to 6, and then x equal to 8. So if you reduce h, the number of calculations increases. So let's do it by step 2 only. So you can write h is 2. So 2 of f of 0, 10 and 40. So k1 comes up to be roughly around how much? 20. So k1 comes out to be 20. And l1, so twice of g of 0, 10 and 40. So if you put the values over here, l1 comes out to be 0.4. Do the calculation. Okay. K2, h times f of x naught plus h by 2, w naught plus. Now, here comes the question there. Now, this is very important. Now, w naught will be, k1 should be added or l1? Now, from which equation w is calculated? So, w is calculated from g function. So, w naught, in this w naught, l1 by 2 will be added. And t is calculated from f. So, t naught plus k1 by 2. Just remember this thing. This is very important. Then only you'll be able to solve. So, k2 will be h times f evaluated at 1. So, 0.2, 10.2. So, this becomes 10.2. 20, 20 half is 10. 10 plus 40 is 50. So, function evaluated at this. So, this will be 10.2, 10.2 into h, that is 24. Similarly, l2 twice of 1, 10.2 and 50. So which comes out to be 0.6. Clear? And then k3, h times f of x naught plus h by 2, w naught plus l2 by 2, and t naught plus k2 by 2. So k3 comes out to be h of 1 by 2, so 10.3, k2 10.2, 10.2 plus 10, or sorry, it's 10.2 plus 40, 50.2. So which comes out to be 20.6. And similarly, L3 will come out to be 0.6. So put these values, okay, and then finally we have K4. So K4 is H times of X naught plus H W naught plus L3 and T naught plus K3. So which comes out to be H times 2, L3 is 0.6, so 10.6 and 20.6 is 60.6. So this comes out to be 21.2. Similarly, L4, H times G value evaluated at these parameters. So 2, 10.6 and 60.6. So this comes out to be somewhere around 0.81. Clear? So now we have all the values of K1, K2, K3, K4 and L1, L2, L3, L4. So K is nothing but 1/6 of K1 plus twice of K2, K3 plus K4. Calculate K. So K comes out to be somewhere around 20.53. And similarly, L, 1/6 of L1 plus twice of L2, L3 plus L4. And this comes out to be roughly around 0.6. So we can say when now X is 2, your Y, not Y, in fact, what was the parameter? It was W. Your W becomes W naught plus L and T becomes T naught plus K. So when X becomes, okay, in fact, X can also be written as, let's write, X is X naught plus H. So when X is 2, W becomes 10.6 and T becomes, in fact, 40 plus 20, 60.53. Clear? So now we have this as the new value, and then again we're gonna repeat the same process. We're gonna find out K1, K2, K3, K4 and L1, L2, L3, L4, and then we'll correspondingly gonna find out for the next, that is X4, X6, X8 and X10. Now for each value of X, will be using RK4 methods, all those values of K1, K2, K3, K4, and then we'll continue to find out the value of W and T till we reach X equal to 10, because if you see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4 divisions. So that's why I've kept H as 2. So step size is 2. So we can find, so this is how you can, you know, even use Rangakuta method to solve this thing. But the only issue is, okay, I'll tell you the issue later on. The only problem over here is the initial value of W. Now, I've already calculated these values of X4, X6, X8, X10. You can simply note it down. We have already solved the calculation for x equal to 2. For x equal to 4, 6 and 10, I'll give you the values. You try it at your places, okay? Now, for x equal to 4, W comes out to be, okay, I'll make a table. That will be easy for us. When W naught was 10, initial value guess was 10, the value of x, w and temperature 0, 10 and 40. So when x was 2, we have a new value of w 20.6 and that's 60.53. So this we calculated using RK method, RK4 method, where you know the value of k was 20.53 and the value of L was 0.6. Now for 4, I've already done the calculation. The value of W comes out to be 11.63 and the value of T comes out to be 82.7. Okay, I can give you the values of K over here. I've applied the Rangakuta method. Finally, I'm giving the overall value of K1 and L. K and L. K comes out to be 22.16 and L becomes 1.03. And then for 6, 13.13, 107.37, and the value of K comes out to be 24.68 and L comes out to be 1.5. You can solve on your own and find out the values of K and L, like we did it for the first case. And then for the 8, it's 15.15 and 135.56, and the value of K comes out to be 28.18 and L is 2.02. And then finally, when we have x equal to 10, W is 17.78 and temperature comes out to be 168.38 and the value of K is 32.82 and L is 2.63. So these are the values which we're gonna calculate using RK4 method. And if you see, so this is, we solved for W equal to 10. Considering the initial value of W is 10, so we have this value. Clear? Now if you see, according to our question, for a length of rod L, the initial conditions are that over here at x equal to 0, the temperature is 40 and at x equal to 10, that is at the length, the temperature is 200. But when we take the W, guess value of W as 10, a random guess of 10, at x equal to 10, the temperature reaches only 168.38. That means it is not somewhere close to what it should be there at x equal to 10, that is at 20. So that means the guess value is somewhat quite less. So now we're going to take another guess value, that W naught, let's say W naught is equal to somewhere at 20. And then again, we're going to proceed with the same calculations of RK4 method. That means instead of now W equal to 10, we're going to take W as equal to 20. And we're going to proceed again with the RK method to find out the values of temperature till we reach x equal to 10. Clear? It's again in the same way. We're going to do it for now new guess value of W as 10. Again, everything remains the same. We just again do the same calculations like we did it in the previous case, in this case. So I've already done. I'll just give you the values. So when W is kept as 20, I'll plot this table only so you can note it down the values. It's again the same thing. Now over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 times we applied RK4 method. Again, in the same case, we're going to apply 4 times RK4 method till we reach W as till we reach x equal to 10. clear? Correspondingly, I'll give you the values of RK, my RK4 values, so that you can, you know, try at your place and you can match the solution. So now when W1O is kept as 20 and temperature is kept 40, so we applied RK method and at x equal to 2, the values is 20.8 and 80.67. So correspondingly, the values of K, I'm giving the values of K, 40.67 and L is 0.8. We know K is 1/6 of K1 plus twice of K2, K3 and K4. So I'm giving the values K and L. So you can find it out at your places. So when X is 4, W comes out to be 22.44 and temperature comes out to be 123.7. Again, the value of K in this second iteration is 43.1 and L is 1.64. When X is 6, this becomes 24.98 and 171.04. The value of K in this case is 47.27 and L is 2.54. Now X is 8, so it becomes 28.52 and this is 224.37. Then this iteration, the K value is 53.33 and L is 3.5. And finally, when X is 10, it is 33.21 and temperature is 285.9. So the value of K in this iteration was 61.53 was K and L was 4.69. So now again this iteration is completed. Now if you see, at when we took W naught as 20, the temperature value at X equal to 10 is 285. So it has to be somewhere around 200. So when W naught and temperature, when W naught, that is initial value of W, when it was 10, temperature at X equal to 10, or let's say not 10, X equal to L, and the value of L is 10. Let me write it as XL, which is 10. The temperature was 168.38. And when the W guess was 20, using RK method, the temperature came out to be 285.9. Whereas actually it should be somewhere around 200. So now we can see that 200 is somewhere in between. Now using interpolation, we're gonna find out the guessed value of W. So at 168 it is 10, at 285 it is 20. So what will be the value of W corresponding to 200? So for that we can use linear interpolation. So we can say that that value will be 10 plus okay, so 20 minus 10 over, what's the value corresponding to 20? 285.9 minus 168.38 into, so we need to find out 200. So 200 minus 168.38. So this value should come out to be somewhere around, let me check, I've calculated it. Yes, so this value comes out to be somewhere around 12.96. So the initial guess of W should be 12.96. Clear? So now we know the initial guess of W as 12.96. So now W naught is 12.96. And again, we're going to apply RK4 method to find out the temperature. To find out the temperatures, clear? Again, like in for W equal to 10, we applied the RK4 method in each iteration, and find out temperature. For W equal to 20, we applied the RK4 method to get temperature at x equal to 10. And similarly, we know the initial gas value. It's 12.96. We're going to apply RK4 method for each value of x and get the value of temperature. I've already done it, so you can note it down, those temperature values. You can try at your places. So when W is 12.96, temperature is 40. So when X is 2, this becomes 13.62, this becomes 66.49. You can get the values. Okay, I'll give you the value of K also. K is 26.49 and L is 0.6. For your reference, you can cross-check the values. When X is 4, W is 14.83. And this is 94.85. And the value of K is 28.36 and L is 1.01. When X is 6, 16.64, 126.22, and K comes out to be 31.36 and L is 1.8. When X is 8, 19.11, 161.85, and in this iteration, the value of K comes out to be 35.63 and L is 2.46. And when X is 10, 22.35, this is 203.17, and the value of K comes up 41.32 and L is 3.2. So you can clearly see when temperature is somewhere around 200 degrees Celsius. So instead of, so now the initial guess of W is 12.96, corresponding to which the temperature at X equal to 10 is somewhere close to 200. Clear? So this is how, so this is the temperature profile we'll be having. So now what we do is the length and the temperature. First, for the initial guess, that is, we're going to plot it for these readings. So we can plot between temperature and length. So this is, you can say, when initial guess was 10. This was when initial guess was 20, and this is the when the initial guess was 12.96, the actual temperature. So I've already plotted it. I can show it to you over here. Now you can see clearly, see, when initial guess was 10, it was the red line. When the initial guess was 20, it's the blue line. And when the initial guess was 12.69, so we reach the exact temperature of 200. So on our calculation, we're getting 203, so no issues with that. So this is the actual profile. The green one is the actual profile of the temperature along the length of the pipe. Clear? So we can clearly see. So this is how, you know, we can solve our ordinary differential equation having a boundary value conditions using shooting method. But the only drawback of this method is the calculations is quite lengthy. Secondly, the initial value has to be taken in such a way that the you closely reaches to the exact value. Otherwise, you know, if I would have taken 100, then this would have been crossed up to, you know, gone up to way beyond this 200. So initial guess is also important. Clear? So this is it with the shooting method. Now, in the next video lecture, we'll solve one non-linear boundary value problem using finite difference method and using shooting method, and then we can compare their results. So it's quite easy that, you know, from shooting point method, finite difference method is quite easy. So that we're gonna see in the next video lecture. So thank you so much.